This building's 100 years old, so we need a new one. If that's the place they choose to put it, you know, then I'm gonna trust that they've made the right decisions.
The city of Des Moines is proposing building a new police station on this property south of MLK Parkway, but there are some obstacles to overcome. That parcel of land is an EPA Superfund site that, in its current state, poses environmental and health risks.
And cleaning it up will cost millions of dollars, which could be shouldered by Des Moines taxpayers. Sonia Hyde-Susan takes a look now at the pros and cons of the proposal in this Channel 13 news investigation.
Once a manufacturing hub, the former Dyco property is now a wasteland. Bordered by Martin Luther King Parkway to the north and the Raccoon River to the south, it could be one of the highest valued properties in Des Moines. But few developers are willing to touch it because of what they do and don't know about contaminants left behind by the former property owner, Dyco Inc. For nearly 40 years, Dyco manufactured wheels and processed chemicals and pesticides here.
I was a press operator.
Otis Alexander worked at the plant in the late 80s through the early 90s. He didn't work with any of the chemicals, but he says he heard stories about them from people who did.
Out the back door on the east side, there was stuff buried there. You hear all kinds of different things.
You'll never see anything living in there.
Frank Swayze heard similar stories while working on the Dyco property.
They told him not to go back there.
He inspected Massey Ferguson parts housed in the now abandoned warehouses on the property.
I talked to longtime employees. They volunteered that I should never take any food or drink in that building at any time and do not work without gloves on. And that I'll never see a living ant, bug, spider, or bird in any of those warehouses. And they were correct.
Swayze quit about 4 months into the job.
Why did you leave?
The place scared me.
Swayze had reason to be concerned. In 1983, the Environmental Protection Agency declared Dyco a Superfund site, a designation given to the most polluted and most hazardous sites in the country. The EPA identified the primary contaminants as trichloroethane, or TCE, and dichloroethylene, also known as DCE. Both are known toxins and cancer-causing agents.
The rumors still exist that there is buried chemicals in the ground.
Former State Senator Jack Hatch was in his first term when the toxins started showing up in Des Moines' drinking water.
And they couldn't find any responsible industry that would own up to the contamination. And so I launched an investigation as a legislator, had public hearings at the Capitol, down here in City Hall, and down in the EPA in Kansas City.
The EPA identified Dyco as the source of the pollutants, but by that time, Titan Tire had purchased the property, making Titan responsible for the cleanup.
Maury Taylor, though, kept on denying that it was his responsibility because he wasn't the owner of the Dyco manufacturing plant, but he bought the plant afterwards. And thus, he also bought the assets and the liabilities.
The liabilities, as Hatch calls them, still exist. In the most recent study, the EPA notes an unacceptable risk to the environment and ecological receptors. The study goes on to say the EPA is performing additional work to determine if the area could present an unacceptable risk to human health. Des Moines Water Works is well aware of those risks.
It's a carcinogen, so of significant concern to us.
Quarterly tests conducted by Water Works still show unacceptable levels of TCE, DCE, and other contaminants in groundwater collected from wells capped off more than 30 years ago.
Part of that piping system actually goes underneath the Raccoon River and extends over near the Dyco facility. That's what's been contaminated over time. We've isolated that off. Literally closed it off so it doesn't create a back problem into the rest of our system.
That's cost Waterworks millions of dollars.
We literally have several million dollars worth of facilities that we've had to isolate off, and we lose several million dollars each year in income simply because that's a raw water source that now we have to turn away from.
As a result, Waterworks CEO Bill Stowe says Waterworks has a lien of sorts on the property.
That property can't be transferred, in our view, without our approval, and any transfer or any use over there, we're going to have to sign off on.
Waterworks isn't the only entity with a stake in this land. Last year, a federal judge ordered Titan Tire to pay the EPA more than $11 million in fines. At last word, Titan planned to appeal that decision. The city of Des Moines would also like to see this cleaned up. City leaders say it's an eyesore. They want to put it back on the tax rolls, or it could be the future home of the Des Moines Police Department.
This site was identified as a very desirable site for that, in the sense that it's centrally located, it has the space to accommodate the needs. So we've identified a much better use for this property.
City Council member Josh Mandelbaum represents this ward. He's also an environmental attorney.
Are you satisfied that if this site is remediated the way it's supposed to be, that it will be safe for people to work here?
Yeah, that's the whole point of the Superfund program.
Last year, the EPA fast-tracked this area for cleanup, but Mandelbaum says additional studies are needed.
There are likely hot spots here that would need to be dealt with or assessed.
That could mean hidden costs. An environmental engineering consultant hired by the EPA estimates the removal of the buildings alone could cost up to $14 million. A highly contaminated pond on the south side of the property must also be capped or dredged, costing another $6.5 million. And then there's the question of dealing with the groundwater and soil contamination. According to the Iowa Department of Natural Resources, the EPA is in the process of reexamining more than 30 years of soil data to determine remediation options and cost.
This contamination, this land, is much more than they thought. We're not talking about millions of dollars, even tens of millions of dollars. This could be hundreds of millions of dollars to clean up and prepare this site.
The city disagrees with that estimate, but acknowledges who pays for the cleanup is part of the negotiation process.
I think we're discussing a range of options, whether that include the city buying the land being donated. I mean, there are a range of options, and we want all those options to be on the table.
To complicate matters, the people we talked with say Titan Management and its previous CEO, Maury Taylor, have been difficult to work with.
Our interactions with the Titan Management have often been contentious, to say the least.
And he's been dancing around his responsibility for so long. It's an example of really corporate greed and corporate blackmail to the city and to the rest of us, thinking or saying that he's going to walk away and leave that for us.
Us means Des Moines taxpayers, and city leaders aren't ruling that out.
Can you guarantee that Des Moines taxpayers will not pick up a big portion of the bill for cleaning up this property?
I mean, I think everything is subject to negotiation.
City leaders say that may be the price taxpayers have to pay to revitalize this important piece of property.
It's a missed opportunity right now. These sites can be a healthy and productive part of our community.
But people with a history here have their doubts.
What did you think when you heard that the city of Des Moines might want to put a police station there?
I was really concerned that they wouldn't let the homeless people sleep on the ground back there, but they were going to plop our best and brightest down on top of that ground.
I think the reality is that nothing will happen. This will remain vacant. We will lose an opportunity to develop a signature piece of this city because of corporate greed.
Sonia Heitzhusen, Channel 13 News.
Throughout the course of this investigation, we called Titan Tire twice and asked a representative to answer our questions about the property, but we didn't hear back until today. Here's a portion of what they had to say in a written statement. The Dyco property has been in full environmental compliance for years and is now in an essentially dormant operation and maintenance phase. As a long-standing corporate citizen of the Des Moines community, it is Dyco's sincere desire to see the property repurposed for the highest and best use of both the community and Dyco. Dyco has been attempting to work with the various applicable governmental entities to achieve this outcome and will continue to do so going forward until it is realized.